done your RN, now they are doing their post-baby program. Now the women, they are married, now they want to use the husband name to do the new program. It's acceptable. But the condition is this. Before you use your married name to run your post-baby program, you must have done your change of name with council. Change your name is 8,750. You must have done that and you have evidence to that effect. The only acceptable evidence is the license. The license must bear the new name. That is an evidence that the change of name has been approved. Anything outside that, we don't take it. So please, let's take note of that. So, and what I usually advise people is this. For me, even if my wife is doing any programs, 10 programs, she's a maiden name she will use. The reason is that I believe if you are running a program, it's better you have the same name on all your certificates. It's important. You have done nursing, now you are doing midwifery. Have the same name on nursing and midwifery certificates. Then when you finish, when you complete the program, you now apply for change of name. The change of name only affects only your license. But on your certificate, you have the same name, consistent, all through, which is better for me. And as long as possible, we should also counsel our students to also do that. The moment they qualify, they pass the exam, they should apply for change of name. It's important. But whoever is it that wants to do change of name, they want to use the new name to run his post-basic program, is allowed. Is allowed. I've made that clear. Post-basic indexing, the requirements. The requirement is the same thing as nursing, as basic nursing. 5 level, English, maths, mathematics, physics, chemistry, biology, all at credit level. However, for post-basic, for those who have done their post-basic, their nursing or midwifery, as at the time when the requirement was just 2 passes, or any other thing, even when the requirement is just maybe 1 pass, and they want to do post-basic now, they can use that same result, 2 passes, to come and run post-basic program in 2017. It's acceptable. So we have to get that clear. You must not insist that they must get the whole level complete. Because as at the time they did their RN, the requirement was different. It was in 2006 that the requirement changed to 5 whole level credits. So anybody who has result, who have done a nursing or basic midwifery before 2006, or even as at 2006, or as at 2006, some of them may even be year 1, as at the time the requirement changed. So by the time they will graduate, maybe around 2007, 2008. So some of them, once the requirement was 2 passes at that time, they should be allowed to run post-basic. So that, I think that we get that clear, right? Do we get it clear? Okay, let me repeat myself. Some said no. Let's assume I did my nursing in 1985. My RN in 1985. And the requirement as a 1985 is just 2 passes. And the 2 passes maybe even is in a Greek or literature in English. And that was what I used to do my nursing in 1985. Now in 2017, I want to go and do A&E. Or pediatrics or any other program in post-basic nursing. That 2 passes I used in doing my RN in 1985, it is the same, the requirement also qualified me in 2017 to run the program. Because at the time I did my nursing, the requirement was different from what it is now. So I'm still eligible to run any program. That's the council's stand on that. But those who finish from 2006 to date, if they want to do their post-basic, they must have the 5 O-level credits. I think it's clear now. So please, let's take note of that. But that may not be applicable to university. Because university, whatever program you are on, you must have the requirement complete. So let's take note of that. I don't know what is applicable in School of Health for public health nursing. Is that? I've not answered your question. Okay, I'm coming. Okay, I still have that here. Okay, so that is on the post basic indexing. Anyway, now somebody said, somebody that came to me on the online program, well, for now, Nigerian government does not accept online program for some of us who are running online MSc in nursing education or online MSc in nursing administration. Nigerian government does not accept that. And since Nigerian government does not accept that, especially all this offshore program, we do not also accept that. Because we rely on whatever government says. So that is an online program. It is not acceptable. Nigerian, the policy of government is that even if you are running a distance learning program, it's expected that at least 60-40, maybe 60% online, 40% you must still have some face-to-face contact. That is Nigerian stand on all these distance learning programs. So, and that is also our stand. So you cannot say you are running a nursing program 100% online. Government does not accept that. The Open University one is acceptable. Because it's within the country and it's been regulated by Nigeria and by Nigerian government. On the exam fee remains for basic. It's the same. Exam fee is fixed. Maybe when I'm sending some of the reports to our email, I will update, I will send all those documents, so that you have all those information at our disposal. The application fee for exam is 8,750. I'll send that to Ross. The amount for paper 1 is 8,750. Paper 2 is 8,750. Paper 3 is 8,750. Then oral practical for basic is 12,750. For post basic is 15,000. Post basic one was just reviewed lately. It was before, actually post basic in specialty areas like in pediatric psychiatry and all that, they don't usually pay the oral practical fee to council. But from November exam, the portal is open now for November exam, and we made it clear all exam fee are to be paid to council's accounts. So we don't keep the practical fee any longer. Council is the one who is going to be paying all the examiners. So it's no longer the teacher of the school to be paying the examiners. I think the head of the officer in charge of post-basic is here. He can give us more clarification on that. Maybe you can come forward, ma'am, so that you give us more information on post-basic examination. I think for now, we have answered all the questions. I don't know, your old man, you say I did not answer that. Why she's coming up to answer, to attend to us on issues on post-basic?
Indexing number, that we don't index with nursing council.
Okay.
We index with West African Health Examination.
Okay, all right, got that.
And the lecturer said that the indexing number will be reflected. So, we use that number.
All right, thank you. I think I got that. I captured that. I think I missed it. The position of council is this. For this registration, the registration will not follow the same pattern. We have some programs that they didn't do the basic program with us. Example is public health nursing being done by School of Public Health Nursing or College of Health Tech. Those ones, they didn't do their nursing, their program with us. They only come to register with us. And for such kind of category of students, we have a different platform for them to do their registration online. So I think we are almost concluding that, but don't worry, it will follow the same pattern. The WAHEP, they do send the result of the exam to us. The moment that is sent to us, that will be captured online. Then it will enable you to do that. The same thing happens to those with public health postgraduate diploma in education. Those ones too, the program is not being regulated by council, so they also use a different platform, registration tab, to to also apply for that. So unlike those who have done their nursing, who have done midwifery, who have now want to register, those ones are strictly our own. So all those external ones, we have as exemption for that. So also foreign trained, we also have some little exemption for that. By the time the thing takes off, all the processing will be detailed information on how the thing will be done, will be made available. And I assure you, it's going to be a simple application that don't give us any stress. Madam?
Good afternoon, everybody. I think Mr. Filade has been able to explain better to us on the mode of payments or style of payment for post-basic nursing specialty. I just want to add that it's just the same thing with how we take care of examiners in the schools of nursing and midwifery. Council will pay them the per diem and the transport fare, but school is responsible, so they're responsible for the accommodation and feeding. Do not say because council is going to pay them and ask them to go and stay in any hotel of their choice. No. You make provision for the accommodation and their feeding, but council is going to pay them for other things. That's what I just want to add to it. I hope you are clear. Thank you.
We are running off for today. I only have just 5 minutes, and the 5 minutes just for us to round up. I don't know. Oh, I've been seeing your hands this morning. Let me hear.
Please, my name is Aulagosh. I want to find out if you already have registration for basic, that is nursing, midwifery, and all that you need to register for, and you go on to do a master's. Do you still need to come back to council for anything?
For somebody who has done nursing?
Yes, you're registered.
Okay.
Maybe you have a specialty, you're registered. You have midwifery, you're registered, and any other thing. And then you go on to do your master's. Do you need to come back to council for anything to register?
No, you don't need to come for council to register. Except if your master's areas, your areas in master's is the type that you that is registrable with, or maybe you do your master's in mental health nursing or community health nursing. That's the only exemption. These are the only ones that are allowed to come back. But if you have up to PhD, it's your own advantage. And you don't need to come back, like you don't use any PhD certificate to register anything with council. The only thing we use in masters are in some few fields, like nursing, education, like mental health nursing, and community health nursing. These are the only areas that we register. Let me move back a little. Let me hear from her.
Good afternoon, all. My name is Owanele Chinwani from the School of Post-Basic, UBTH. Please, mine is just an appeal to Dr. Sam. It's in respect of our registration as nurse tutor or nurse educators. I'm happy or I'm glad to see that she's in our midst. It's quite a long time we sent our documents to the council, but there was a kind of hitch as a result of the open university issue. So I'm appealing that now that they have lifted up the ban, if she can use her good office to help us, because very soon the council is coming for accreditation. So that
thank you. We've registered everybody. So you just told us that notifications are ready. We have registered.
Okay, in addition to that, some of us, we need to get this information clear. Like the one she raised now, those who are open university, I told you whether open, closed or closed open, all are acceptable. So, and those who have registered to apply for tutor or for as a tutor before now, they've all registered them. So, those who have that, they can come forward and do that. But you must know that for those who have applied, we don't provide notification to schools. You must come in person to come and pick those things up. We don't worry about it, so please put that. This not only tutor, all notification letter and certificates, we don't worry about it to schools or to individuals. It's only licenses that are sent to our donor or to institutions. institutions. But for notification as advocate, we don't do that. Please, let's take note.
I want to find out about indexing of our students. In the recent time, we have been having students that are already married and they come for the BNSC program. And you stated that when they are due for indexing, the names, their many names must appear. But most times, these students will insist that they want to index with their married names. So at that point, can we now scan their affidavit or their marriage certificate together with their certificates?
Alright, I think I've answered this earlier. Those who have done change of name, and who wants to run a program with their new name, their married name, they must do change of name with us. We are not against that. But what we are saying is that the change of name process must have been concluded. For the fact that you paid for change of name does not mean that the change of name has been effected. There are a lot of people who apply for change of name, but for several reasons, the change of name application will not be done. I'll give you some of the reasons. One, those who are using compound name, they compounded their name. Meanwhile, by the time they're doing newspaper publication, their name in the new administration does not appear as a compound name. Even the marriage certificate they are presenting, the name does not, it was not compounded. But now they want to compound the name on their license, on the change of name, and such, they won't approve it. So make sure that the change of name has been concluded. And we told you the evidence for that is the license. So once you have your license, and this habit bearing the new name, you don't have any problem with that. We can admit, but I've told you from experience, I will encourage the student, let them run the program with their maiden name. But if they insist they want to use their married name, let them go and do their change of name and get it done properly. Probably, you'll be the last person.
James Adelekaru from Delta State. I have two questions. One of them is concerning registration of nurse administrators. I've been a victim for about 2 years now. I've been trying to process my registration, but the problem is my transcripts. I've made every necessary payment both to council and to the school. But it seems UniBen is not, I don't know what actually is the problem. They are unwilling to send that transcript, despite several efforts to them. So I don't know, because they just finished a verification in my facility, and I was told that I don't have a practicing license. So I don't know why I should bear the brunt. And I want to ask, is it possible for council to liaise with UniBen, being that they are the only nurse administrators trainer in this country, to send results of their students to them, details of their students? That is my number one question. Then the second one is, I discovered that there are some training going on in other institutions like dental training now. They call it dental nursing. People that have not gone through nursing, what is council doing about this? Is it possible for somebody to just do something related to nursing without doing general nursing?
Alright, I need to round up. We have people are waiting for us outside for other things. Please, let me say this. Like the issue you raised on the registration, this thing, I would advise that you meet the head of registration. She will counsel you on what to do on that. But on the issue of a lot of programs being run, there are a lot of them. We are aware of that, like dental nursing, like oncology nursing, what other program? Which other one? Renal nephrology nursing. OBM is not a program. So, what am I trying to say? All these programs, as far as can be, they are not accredited programs. We must note that any institution running dental program, dental nursing, nephrology nursing, oncology nursing, they are not accredited. The list of accredited programs in Nigeria are already on our website. So you should let people know about it. All those programs they are running, they are not registrable with us. But council is actually working on developing modules, curriculum for all these programs, so that in no distance time the programs may take up. But for now, that has not been done. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any comment or contribution or question, note it down. When we come here tomorrow, we'll continue. Shall we rise up for closing prayer? I want to use this medium to thank all of us for your cooperation since morning up to this moment.